My name is Jyothy Puthumana, and I'm a cardiologist here at Northwestern Medicine, Associate Professor of Medicine, Feinberg School of Medicine. I'm also the Medical Director of the Martha and Richard Melman Bicuspid Aortic Valve Program here at Northwestern Medicine. We know that bicuspid aortic valve disease affects about 1.5 to 2% of the general population. However, we know that among the patients that we see, there is 5 to 7 times more likelihood that there will be another family member who could be affected either with a bicuspid aortic valve disease that is as yet undiagnosed, or an aortic enlargement, an aortic aneurysm that can be the sole manifestation in some of the family members. Hence, the screening of family members is an integral part of taking care of patients with bicuspid valve disease to identify disease in other family members that have not yet been identified. We have a bicuspid aortic valve registry that now has close to 700 to 800 patients that we are following longitudinally along with updates on a yearly basis as it relates to their imaging and other outcomes. And this, we feel, over the course of the next 2 to 3 decades is going to be a powerhouse of information to be able to predict the different trajectories of our patients with bicuspid valve disease. For the bicuspid aortic valve program, we have been using newer tools in both transthoracic and transesophageal echocardiogram to help identify the disease process and help us fine-tune our decision-making regarding timing for interventions. Specifically, we've been using three-dimensional echocardiography to help with better quantification of left ventricular volumes, volumes of the aortic insufficiency and stenosis, thereby helping us make more precise timing referrals for these patients who may need an intervention. The most prominent area of research over the past 10 years has been the role of non-invasive imaging, specifically MRI and 4D flows, in identifying higher patients with higher disease morbidity to help identify and prognosticate these patients. Dr. Michael Markle and his team have been leaders in the world, both initially with developing the technique of 4D flows and then adapting it in this specific population. So we've benefited immensely from his research, which has been published extensively over the past 10 years in more than 150 publications, showing that the tools of 4D flow MRI is able to better identify patients who have abnormalities of the aorta related to bicuspid aortic valve disease. But more recently, they have also been able to show that some of these patients who have a large area of aortic abnormality as identified by MRI are the patients who are likely to progress and would need closer follow-up with us. In addition, there has been an excellent correlation of those of our patients who have undergone surgery who have had a 4D flow MRI done prior to surgery to identify location within the aorta that was abnormal when identified by MRI. So what is shown non-invasively correlates with what has been shown in actual tissue in the lab. The work was significant enough that Dr. Markle and his team have now a multi-year NIH-funded multi-million dollar grant to look at patients prospectively using 4D flows in those who are undergoing surgery. Teaming up with the bicuspid aortic valve specialists at Lurie Children's Hospital has added more strength to our program and given us the entire gamut of patients with bicuspid valve disease from infancy into late adulthood, into late stages of their life. This really sets us apart and gives us an unique ability clinically, but looking forward, even research-wise, to follow these patients from birth till the end of an intervention or to the end of their lives to give us the global perspective of this disease. In addition, the research that we have with the Bridge program that includes children transitioning on to adult gives us a very unique opportunity to identify some children who had a severe manifestation of this disease and to see how their clinical course varies and the timing of their interventions and what helps us to follow them closely. From the cardiac surgical side, Dr. Malajri and his team and Dr. Fedak have been involved with multiple bicuspid valve-related research studies, looking at outcomes in these patients, looking at aortic valve repair, looking at the type and timing of aortic aneurysm replacements, and the data from here has been at the forefront of most of the bicuspid medical and cardiac surgical care that has changed practice across the world.